Don't make this Quran a pillow. Don't throw it on your backs. Don't just have a feeling that you have it and take pride out of it. وَتْلُوهُ حَقَّ تِلَاوَتِهِ فِي عَنَاءِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ. Recite it during the daytime also and the time of night also. Do it. Number two, وَفْشُوهُ. Spread it. Ifsha. If we say in Urdu, Raaz ifsha ho gaya, Raaz ka ifsha hai. Ifsha is spread. This has come for the whole of humanity, not for you only. As I quoted the ayah in the previous session, the Prophet has commanded to every Muslim, بَلَّغُوا أَنِّي وَلَوْ آيَةً. No Muslim should think that I don't have any responsibility of the conveying of the message of Quran. Even if you know one ayah, you convey this ayah to the other. There can be, you know, no further emphasis can be there. It's the highest form of emphasis that the Prophet ﷺ is laying on this. بَلَّغُوا أَنِّي وَلَوْ آيَةً. Even if you can convey one ayah, think that it is your duty to convey it. Learn more and convey more. خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ وَعَلَّمَهُ. The best amongst you are those who keep on learning more and more Quran. And whatever they are learning and understanding, they share it with others, convey it to the others also. خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ وَعَلَّمَهُ. رواه البخاري عن عثمان بن عفان رضي الله تعالى عنه. Third is وتغنوه. Feel that you are rich because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you Quran. This is the most precious thing on the surface of the earth. Allah's kalam, Allah's word. And Allah's word is one of His attributes. This attribute has been revealed to you in your language. So actually, you should have the feeling that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you the biggest precious thing in the world that is possible. The ayah in Surah Yunus says, Ya ayyuhan nas, qad ja'atkum mau'izatun min rabbikum wa shifa'un lima fi sudur wa hudan wa rahmatun lil mu'minin. Qul bi fadlillahi wa bi rahmatihi fa bi dhalika falyafrahu huwa khairum mimma yajma'un. This Quran is more precious, more valuable than all the other things that people possess. Don't think that he possesses a very big mansion, a very big building. He lives in a very big palace. So he's more fortunate. If you are thinking in those terms, you don't know the value of Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you. This is more precious than all the belongings and possessions of this earth or this world. Huwa khairum mimma yajma'un. So rejoice that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you such a precious thing. So the third commandment which came in this hadith is, وَتَغَنَّوْهُ.